Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to a very special Fireside Chats here on Island FM. Welcome to Debate 20XX, the political special of the day. As we all know, ladies and gentlemen, it's coming to this time of year. We got to vote in the town gatherer, the one who shall usher in from the rooftops and shout at what is the plans of the day. What the cabal of freaks and Big Jim Duff is planning for this fine island that I call a home. And now today we have a very fine group of individuals here. We have a B. Adger.
Welcome. Hello.
Welcome, Mr. B.
Hello.
From an undisclosed location, we have good old-fashioned, for also second time on the show, Seamus O'Shea.
I'm back, and you might be wondering how I survived.
We are all very curious, Mr. O'Shea.
Magnets.
Magnets, oh yes, they are truly the great defense against the bullet. One that is one I'm currently
Unfortunately, of course, Mark Smith is currently still in critical condition. The old host of Fireside Chats, he's currently in critical condition. He's paralyzed from the eyebrows down, and he needs all our help and support. So if I'm personally claiming that if I become down gatherer, I will put him out of his misery.
Well, that is great of you, Mr. O'Shea. I know the nurses are working around the clock to try and help him. They've tried to work communication.
They've said there's never been a dirtier coma patient.
It's been pretty bad. They've tried to communicate him by using his eyebrows, but instead they have to use but from hair movements. It's been difficult.
It's very difficult. So this debate goes out to him. And again, if I win, I will be legally allowed to shoot him in the head. And put him out of his misery.
Last up, we have, coming hailing from the south of the island, we have the Brigadier.
It's good to be here, Mr. O'Reilly.
The Brigadier, now, I want to start this debate. I first of all want to say that me and Big Jim Duffy have settled our differences. We had I visited him on his plantation, and I killed his third son in a fair duel. So now we're okay. We've solved it all. It's all to bed. He has claimed he is known to do. He will forgive anything if you kill one of his sons in a fair duel. You have to fairly duel him with swords. So Brigadier. Now I don't. My question to you is: are you a badger?
Why was that such a ridiculous
Because I was.
Person.
I've been given inside information that one of these men, one of the men in the debates, is a badger, and I'm not a badger. I know that much.
That is an outrageous statement to say to me.
It seems like a thing a badger would bring up.
Let's get off this. Let's talk about the actual issues. Let's talk about the issues. Fair access to debates. We're going to legalize ice cream vans again. We're going to illegalize poison.
I'm sorry, Miss O'Shea. That is my job here. As the moderator.
You're not doing a good job, Dan.
Well, I'm working it in now.
Okay.
Mr. O'Shea. Thank you.
All right.
I'm sorry
for
getting a bit aggro.
It's okay. I'm sorry.
The metal trousers, they've been really working on my nerves in the
You're
past
still wearing
days.
Them, are you?
I got to prove the patent, all right?
Well, if I'd worked in that patent office, I would have warned you it's dangerous.
I talked to Mr. Sanchez, and he said, you got to wear them for a month straight.
You got to stop listening to Miguel Sanchez. He is a textbook villain.
Well, he's helped me in the past, but we'll see how it goes. But for the debate, now we'll start off with you, Mr. O'Shea.
We should have maybe written some of these topics down before the
Probably,
debate.
Yes.
But okay, what's the first topic? I'll be happy to discuss anything.
Okay. What are the big changes that you want to see for the island as the town gatherer?
Like I said, I'm going to legalize ice cream vans again. They've been illegal for 10 years now, ever since that one didn't have enough 99s when Big Jim came at it and he shot the driver and burnt the ice cream van in front of all those kids, traumatizing them for life. But you know what? Hey, that's life on the island. I'm going to illegalize poison because I feel like it's been used too much lately. And I don't know about you guys, but I feel like I'm sick of having diarrhea. And just that mild level of poison that people put in food and everything, to, you know, train our bodies to survive poison attacks. I think it's not okay. I also want to repave the road, road A5, just because it's in bits. And Pizza on Fridays.
Pizza on Fridays.
Pizza on Fridays. Very impressive. In the town hall.
Well,
for all.
That is definitely
pizza for everyone.
It is definitely the most compelling point I've heard today. Fair play to you, Mr. O'Shea.
Well, thank you.
Mr. Adger, what are your points today? What do you want to change as the town gatherer?
I agree with Mr. O'Shea on legalizing poison. Feel some poisons aimed at certain people. Also, want to bring in policy of unlocked doors at night.
Unlocked doors?
Feel if doors are locked brings across sense of...
I hate to interrupt, but if we leave doors unlocked, then we leave ourselves open to attacks by the Midnight Gooser. We don't want him coming in again. Remember him? Remember him, everybody?
He touched
your bum?
He
wouldn't like it?
Pretty bad. Individual death.
He'd sneak in. He'd be like, sneak, 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 sneak. Squeeze, squeeze.
I've gotten into
he was a real prick.
Mr. Hodger, feel doors locked makes people not trust each other. Open doors, sense of community.
Mr. B. Adger, you don't even live in a house. You live in a hillock in the woods. So what are you even talking? So you're claiming you want to unlock doors for everyone else, but not for yourself. You're a classic politician. The rules don't apply to you.
Check.
I think this is why I don't want anyone voting for this guy, because he's scum. I have it on good authority, that he has at least 3 wives.
Where is evidence for statement?
Miss O'Shea, this is an incredibly defamatory statement. Now,
my lawyer, Miguel Sanchez, said another thing I have here is defamation. Because saw it with his own 2 eyes.
Now, Miss O'Shea, as the representative of Island FM, I am contractually obliged to say that we do not support these statements whatsoever. But as an individual, Mr. O'Reilly, I think these comments should be pursued to the fullest extent of the law. We should pursue the individual, Mr. Adger, and make sure that these wives that claim do exist, because there's been an epidemic of false wives on this island.
As you know, many men have got false wives. Those fake wives they put
it
up
is,
in the window
is
to
too
claim
much.
That they're not, so they don't get brought in by Big Jim Duffy's anti-incel brigade.
It has been too much, as we
all... You know,
all
Big Jim, he goes around in that van, that beautiful van of his, and he collects all the single men who are single past a certain age, 35. And we know what he does. He brings them to the plantation, and some of them become workers in his carnival. Others become part of his cabal of freaks after hours of torture. And, some of them end up in the pits.
Now, before we move on...
The body pits, of course.
Now, before we move on, it must be very important to actually nail out this statement throughout. So, Mr. De Brigadier... you have a long history of having fake wives. Is that correct?
There may be a few encounters of where I've falsified my wife's identity.
You falsified wives. You have fake wives. Let me meet your. Is your wife current? Do you have currently a real wife?
Legally speaking, yes.
Legally speaking?
Yes, I've worked pretty long for this, and it is recognized in the county of Dublin that this mannequin makeup is a wife.
A what?
A wife.
No, what is a wife? American makeup?
The mannequin that I put makeup on. And that is why I'm leading on the platform of recognizing makeup mannequins as wives on the island.
This is a very controversial statement you are taking.
I completely disagree with this, because I don't believe if that's true that I legally have to marry my makeup mannequin, and I refuse to do it.
Will draw the legal reason?
Because she's a bitch.
Mr. Archer, feel if legalizing makeup mannequins
as wives.
Delegitimizes his 3 marriages, the sanctity of traditional marriage.
Traditional polyamorous marriage, which is, of course, legal on the island.
But this is what all of us mannequin.
Look, the Brigadier. Look, Brigadier. We all have makeup mannequins. We all have them in our homes.
I don't.
How else do? Yeah, you don't have a home though, do you? You live in a hillock.
It's an open hillock.
You live in a hole for dinner that you grow. Yeah, that's how I know.
Gentlemen.
You live in a hole. You dug in the ground.
Gentlemen, please.
With your claw-like appendages. I don't know what to call this man.
Sir, Mr. O'Shea.
He doesn't live in a real house.
I must ask
you. You don't live in a real house.
I live in a houseboat. I live in a houseboat, and it's parked on the river.
With your mother.
Well, yeah, but she's very sick. What am I with?
Mr. O'Shea's mother has been having a long medical history. She needs her help.
My mother needs her medical, her makeup mannequin to do her makeup in the morning, or else, and that's the only reason I still have one. My wife hates it.
Refer to...
And my secret wife hates it.
Refer to my policy outlined on the sick.
Yes, I see it now. I'm looking at it right now. It's just a bunch of scratches on a page. It's a dirt on a page. There's no word. Are you illiterate, sir? Can you read it right?
Sounds like you're illiterate.
Sir!
Can you read this down?
O'Shea?
Can you read this? These are scribbles.
No, I can
this
read
is
it
dirt
fine.
On it. What does it say?
It's saying... I'm sorry. My scratch mark is a bit rough today. Give me a work. It says, help. Help me. No, help you. Mr. Archie, you gotta give me a helpie. It's been many years since I've read Badger.
The weak and sick.
Wait a minute.
Should be consumed.
Mr. O'Shea, do you not know how to write Badger? It is one of the most important written dialects
on the island. Hold on a second. He writes Badger?
Yes. I write Badger every now and again. Not for your communications to other human beings.
I just think this man's very suspect. From his claw-like appendages,
sir,
to his badger-like den.
Mr. O'Shea, we're not here to accuse if anyone in this room, also in secret locations, are not badgers.
Right. That technically is the job of the anti-badger brigade.
Yes.
And of course, they're an offshoot of the anti-insult brigade.
So, gentlemen, next question from the audience. Define... the town gatherer. Now, this is a very important topic that comes up every year that not everyone can answer. Gentlemen,
let me just read the old. I remember.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so.
Please play Mr. O'Shea.
So, town gatherer job is to once a week go visit Big Jim and his plantation. And receive the edicts for the week of what is now legal, what's illegal. Give suggestions of what should be illegal and what's illegal. And then return to the town hall. Stand on the top of town hall. Get the megaphone, the sound system, the boom boxes. You know, the sound system we built with that's 200 boom boxes. And it's 200 boom boxes high and 200 boom boxes wide.
Yes, for some of the citizens with more sensitive hearing, it is... torture.
As everyone else back home, he's referring to the Tower of Sound.
And we get on the megaphone into the microphone, and we shout out the edicts for the week, and then we gather certain people in the town hall, and they get sent to the plantation for various
offering.
Well, that's just part of living on the island. Sometimes you gotta go to Big Jim's plantation, and sometimes you don't come back.
That is a good start, Mr. O'Shea. The answer is deemed acceptable. Mr. the Is it actually the Brigadier?
Yes.
Can I just call you Mr. Brigadier?
That is an insult to my entire public.
His first name is there. His surname is Brigadier. Get it right. You are polite and you call him his full title, the Brigadier. He doesn't live on that. He doesn't live in that castle made out of styrofoam peanuts for nothing.
My father spent many a year going by a Brigadier, and he fought incredibly hard to get the name back.
Okay then, Mr. the Brigadier. What do you think are the responsibilities of the town gatherer?
Many responsibilities of the gatherer themselves. It involves God bring the pound folk.
Yes, Mr. the Brigadier. That is one.
That's one. We all know that one.
May you elaborate on this?
Yes, of course I can. So once again, my pound folks, you distribute the rifles.
Sir, we are all armed.
I know that. I mean, the muskets. The muskets of old.
Yes, as we... Oh, yes, the old muskets of our
of course,
ancestors.
The rusty muskets. And I'm not talking about the strip club.
Indeed, Mr. O'Shea, indeed.
Of course, I just want to take this time to say my run for town gatherer is being sponsored by the Rusty Musket. Come down to Rusty Musket, where all the ladies wear powdered wigs.
Aren't the wigs powdered with lead?
You're not allowed in there anymore for after what you did to Sally. He ripped her face off.
That is truly problematic. And so, once you've got pound folks and line them side by side on the edge of the road, you give them all the muskets. But only one is armed.
I'm sorry, wait, you're giving them armed muskets, Mr. the Brigadier.
That is correct. And so we play the unreal game of who has the musket. And everyone goes in order, pointing at an individual that I hate, and pulls the trigger. And someone dies. It is truly one of the grandest traditions of the island that I am proud to continue as a town gatherer.
And I thank you for your service for continuing it even when it wasn't your job as town gatherer.
Yes, it was.
Because your father was... Now, your father was the last town gatherer. Before he died in that Putchin Steel accident.
But it was pretty bad losing...
It didn't explode. It fell on him.
It was pretty sad losing a brigadier. It was a sad day for the family.
Thank you for service.
Bruce out salute. He was an actual brigadier.
We'll do a 20 musket salute later.
And thank you, Mr. the Brigadier. This is also being deemed a acceptable answer. Mr. B. Adger, what are the responsibilities of the town gatherer?
I feel the purpose of town gatherer is to ensure fair deal for all citizens. Things are not just black and white. They are also shades of gray.
Can you elaborate on this fair deal? In what area of life?
Certain citizens on the island face unfair persecution.
That is correct. The Mann family has been working through horrible times recently.
Well, they lost their most beautiful son.
Yes, it was a sad day for the family.
He fell down that hole. That badger hole.
Yes, the badger hole was pretty horrendous.
It was pretty big.
Yes.
A lot of people asked, how did you not see it? But of course, the most beautiful man was also the blindest.
Truly very sad.
Badger, Mr. B. Adger, also feel rising sea levels around the island threaten to flood in some dens.
Climate hoax. This guy's talking climate hoax. This isn't... There's no problem with the water.
Sir, please, this is a political show. No controversial opinions. We gotta get ourselves back on topic.
Okay, what's the next one?
Okay, we're moving on to Bulletproof Bakery. Now, as we all know, people, Bulletproof Bakery has been encountering many robberies and increase over the last couple of weeks. And
they turned to the barter system.
Indeed, they have.
I traded in a pair of slacks for a really nice cake there last week. Walked outside, it got robbed on me.
Yeah.
A man with a bandit mask walked up and said, give me the cake. And I said, you can take it with my cold dead hands. And he shot me in the stomach.
Ah, the cake bandit.
Many are unclear why there's so much robberies at the bakery. Some may claim it's just a problem with the area. Others may claim it's the bandit camp 200 meters away. But no one can tell.
I have a real... Dan, if I could step in here, Mr. O'Reilly, I have the ultimate solution for this problem.
Please, Mr. O'Shea, go on.
We all know him. We all love him. Revolver Jones, the living gun. We need to get him down there doing his thing. Every day, not dawn to dusk, being Revolver Jones, the living gun.
If I can take a minute of your time. Bulletproof Bakery needs protection. And I appreciate Mr. O'Shea wanting to provide it with the walking gun, Revolver Jones.
But a living gun.
I will recognize the living gun when they recognize the make of mannequins. But Revolver Jones isn't good enough. He's got revolver in his name. How can you trust a revolver? It ain't a musket.
Revolver Jones has proven himself again and again as a savior of this town. He was there. He was there when we had to fight that giant bee. That time we had to win that singing competition.
Well,
and he sang Firework by Katy Perry.
And also pointing off.
It was beautiful.
And also pointing off.
I cried so much.
And also pointing off the combinations of budgets and coyotes. He has totally done God's work. But he was only one man. What we need is.
He's one gun.
Indeed. But what we need is a brigade. We need a firing line.
Your musket brigade again.
We need a firing line outside Bulletproof Bakery. Blind them red coats, armed rifles, ready to shoot at and take that moves.
Your musket brigade not only cost the taxpayer thousands of pound of coins
and one gold coins.
They failed to take back the south of the island. And they did far too much pillaging.
They done the job. Watch what they were intended to do. Protect my house.
I may not know much, but it seems a man who can, you know, use whatever he uses immediately is better than 20 people who take half an hour. By that time, bandits have run away.
Roger, they don't all fire at once. You all utilize the firing line where the first line fires and while they reload, the second line fires. And while they reload...
We all understand how musket lines work. But the problem is...
Everyone in the island is trained.
These men don't understand. These men aren't good at what they do. They're slow to reload and they don't use weapons. They're superior weapons. Lever action revolvers and rifles.
They can hit a budget from 100 meters away.
But the muskets are also incredibly rusty. Incredibly rusty.
Shout out to the rusty musket. If you catch crabs, your dance is free.
And that's what we must be deploying with the bandits. Because the moose makes them more dangerous. It's the person to kill them the infection will.
You have attempted this prior to the campaign, and half your men died.
Gentlemen, please, we have spent enough time on Bulletproof Bakery. These have been very great points for the voting base, and I say they have much to discuss. I, for one, don't care, so we're going to move on.
Yeah, you're celiac, you can't wait, you gotta go to the bakery, can you? By choice, right?
Indeed. People said it couldn't be done. Great show, gentlemen. Next question brought in by the general public. The weather has been an incredible problem on this island, especially with the recent case by Miguel Sanchez. So whether or not should the weather return? Mr. Adger, what do you plan to do with the weather?
I have a group of, one might say, shamans working to communicate with the weather.
I want to jump in right now. Is it not five minutes ago? Mr. A. Badger here claimed...
B. Adger.
B. Adger.
I haven't got your name wrong.
What's my name?
Mr. O'Shea.
Damn
it. Mr. O'Shea.
Not 5 minutes ago, Mr. A. B. B. Adger, sorry, claimed that the water, the rain was so bad the water was rising in his den.
House.
I assumed you were talking about the den, the room in your house.
My man cave. We all have man caves.
Even though I'm pretty sure I said earlier he lives in a hole. Anyway, cut that out. So now he's claiming there's no weather. This guy flip flops more than the shoes. How can this man be trusted to be town gatherer? He will fold like a folding knife in front of Big Jim Duffy. Second Big Jim Duffy says anything, he's going to fall.
I will capitulate.
For me, I think we got the sun in the sky. Who cares about a bit of
gentlemen,
rain?
Gentlemen, please.
US.
Mr. the Brigadier wants a button in here, so let's give him one more. Mr. Archer,
aren't we supposed shamans affiliated with the Shaman Union? I'm sorry, Mr. Archer, but I'm affiliated with the Shaman Union.
What?
What? It's very easy to understand him. He's asking you a question. Just answer him, Mr. Beaver.
We're not discussing the Shaman Union.
He's talking about the Shaman Union. This man doesn't know a thing.
That sounds like something a badger would say.
I'm not a badger.
Notice how unintelligible he is.
Do you think
badgers could speak human tongue?
Our
tongue?
I'm insulted by accent, Mr. Badger. This is pretty unlike accent.
It sounds like the sounds you are making aren't from human vocal cords.
All right, gentlemen, I'm sorry, but we have to move on to the final topic of the day.
How long has this debate been on? Because usually I don't think debates last 6 hours.
Oh, it lasts as long as I deem it long enough, Mr. O'Shea.
Okay, well, as we all know...
Sounds like egotism. You should be in politics.
All right, final question of the day, gentlemen. Let's wrap this show up. Now, as we all know, the badger population has been an increasing problem on the island. It has led to many deaths, and people are concerned. What are your ideas to deal with the rising badger test?
Full-scale
Sir, Mr. O'Shea, I'm tossing this to Mr. Adger first. My apologies. Mr. Adger, how do we kill the badgers?
I feel they're misunderstood.
This man's married to a badger, and he thinks that makes him understood. I say marriage. What is it? Under the eyes of God, I believe it's considered a sin to marry an animal, but whatever.
Not on the island. I've read the codes.
You're right, there is no law. There's no God's law on this island,
one of Big Jim Duffy's wives is a horse.
Yeah, and he ate her.
I'm pulling a razor cuff my eyes.
Literally and figuratively.
Sexually and literally.
Yeah, he ate her.
Remember what he said on his wedding night? Do you remember? Everyone remember what Big Jim Duffy said on his wedding night?
Refresh
my memory.
The only thing better than murder is horse pussy!
Butter is a spot on impression of Mr. Duffy.
Listen, Badger. We don't want your opinions here.
You call it great and Badger. I'm the Mr. Badger.
Guys. Shit, that's the gigger. I'm out of here.
Gentlemen, we gotta run.
That's the guy. Get it. Shut everything down.
Be Badger number one.
Get your guns.
Next up on Island Radio, we have the sultry sounds of seagulls fighting over a slice of bread.